Welcome back to my channel, friends. It's like Sonia here, and today you can see I have a nice glass jar. So these are the jars which you get with a few of the kitchen groceries, like a few of the edibles, the ready packs ones. And I have bunch of these glass jars which I use in my kitchen. So once they get empty, I just clean it really well, and then I use it for storing the few of the groceries which I need really less in quantity or which I need to fill up very frequently. So these glass jars are just perfect for it. So the bottom one is something which I love to have a clear one, so that when I open my cupboard, my kitchen cabinet, I can see what is there inside. But for the lid, these are the metal tin lid, and of course I need to work on this because these are looking so dull and so bad. So I just thought that why not to do some decoupage work and mixed media work on this. So usually when we do decoupage, we do the we prep up the base with the white shade, but here I don't want to use the white shade because I want to have this natural rustic look, and I want to use this beautiful decoupage napkin. So what I'm thinking is that I'm going to keep the colors very natural here, and I want to have some nice floral pattern on the top of it. So I'll keep my lid upside down and I'll start cutting it. So I just need to be a little careful because I want my central flowers, the bunch of flowers which is there on the decoupage napkin, to be there. And yeah, this looks good. Now here I have my Mod Podge, and I'm going to take a flat brush. It's a flat brush number 5. And now first let me remove the plies, and this was super easy. This is already, the ply was actually already coming out. Let me see if there is any other layer to know. Okay, so this decoupage napkin had just one layer. Now before doing this process, you need to make sure that your base is really clean. So this looks dirty, but this is really clean and there's no dust at all on this lid. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to complete the I'm going to cover the complete area with the decoupage glue. Yes, now this is done. Be a little quick because of course we don't want this to dry out, and make sure that you don't overdo your decoupage glue. Now let me layer this up, but before that I'll take up a flat brush so that I can use that for sticking, and now I will apply this. Okay, now with a flat brush I'm going to quickly run it over my base, and you can see that it is already taking the shape of my cap. Now here what you need to do is you need to cut it into smaller pieces. This is just to make sure that when you stick it, it sticks really well and there are less wrinkles. So here definitely you will have to add more Mod Podge. That's absolutely fine. Adding a Mod Podge is a good thing because it sticks your project really well. And please don't be like, oh, I'm using too much of Mod Podge, or I'm just going to finish on my bottle vase. That's absolutely fine, because once you do your project, it should last long. So yeah, here I'm done. Now with the same brush, I'll apply a good layer of Mod Podge again. And wherever I'm sticking my napkin, wherever I'm applying my decoupage glue, I'll make sure that I keep on sticking my napkin. And you need to be a little careful, and it's done. So I'm just applying a good amount of Mod Podge on the sides, and then immediately I'm covering it up with my napkin. Now you need to finish up this process quickly, because from the top you will have to press it with your another brush. I'll show you very quickly. Let me just finish this one. So I really love this process of decoupage, because this actually gives a complete new look to any of your older or the scrap pieces. And like I said, I love, love, love using these jars. So just imagine that how beautiful it is going to look when you give them a new makeover. Okay, so now this is done. I'm just running my Mod Podge brush over it so that if there is any wrinkles or anything, it comes out. Okay, now this is done. Now this looks really amazing. I'm just making sure that I have not left out any of the areas without my Mod Podge, and I have pressed it well. So yeah, now this is done. Now I'm going to let it dry for some time and then we will be back. It's time to move on to the next step. My lid has dried out completely and now I will be removing the excessive decoupage napkin. And here I'm using my nail filer. You can use sandpaper or you can even use any other mediums, the tools which you like. So this is something which I really love. I love, love, love using my nail filer for this. I know it's really weird, but I love it and it works for me. So this tip, like whenever you're doing the removing of your napkins, always use your tool or your filer or your sandpaper from napkin to the other side of the base. So that don't do it this way. Don't take it from base to your napkin. Take it from napkin to your base, and this will make sure that your napkin is not coming out from the areas where you are working. Let me just remove all these papers which is just coming out. This is the coating which was done on this lid. And like I said, I am going to use this to store my food. So of course, I want these lids to be really, really clean. Okay, so here I have removed all the excessive decoupage napkin and the sheets what were coming out. This looks really neat and clean. Can you really see the difference? So I'll just show you another lid. This is how it was looking earlier and this is how it looks now. This looks beautiful. This looks really, really beautiful. Now I am going to use my black color paint on the inner side of my lid. Why I'm doing this now? Because later on I'll just do my mixed media work and I'm going to keep it aside to dry completely. So here with a flat brush, I am applying a good coat of paint on my lid. Now you have to be really careful when you're doing this. Of course, we don't want to paint our decoupage part, so just be a little careful. Now for this process, I'm using my flat brush number 5, the same one with which I had used my Mod Podge. Let me take some color here on the lid. Okay, now this is done. Now only on the edges I will be doing the coloring work, and for this I'll be really, really careful. Just a touch of black color on the edges. Please make sure that you don't do too much of coloring here, only on the edges. This is just going to make sure that your lid looks neat and clean and the finishing looks good. So yeah, here I'm done. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to quickly use my heat gun. This is just to speed up my process of drying. I just realized that I have messed out this space, and now I'll go back to my heat gun. Now, once it has dried out, I'm going to use my second coat of paint. Now, the acrylic paints, they dry out on metal really fast, and especially if you use your heat gun, they will dry out in just few seconds. But you need to make sure that you use your heat gun and the tools and paint it properly. So now here I'm done with my black color paint. Very quickly, I will be using my heat gun again to dry up the second coat. This looks really good now, actually. This is looking really nice. Okay, so now my lead has dried out completely. This is looking beautiful, absolutely gorgeous. Again, I would like to show you the comparison. That this is how the older it was looking, and the older one looked, and now this is one is looking this way after the makeover, and this looks gorgeous. Now I need to add some embellishments, of course, and here I have these paper flowers. I'm just checking if I need to remove the plies. No, so I don't have to remove the plies, so that's the best thing. Now this is the empty area, so here I will add two blue dots, and I will add these flowers here. If you want, you can even use your glue sticks, and if you want, you can even use some other adhesives, the liquid adhesive. I chose to use glue drops just because I like them. I absolutely love them. Now just with my tool, I'm just bringing up all the layers up so that when you see the lid from the sides, it looks a little popped out. Done. Now I need to add something in the center, and for that I'm not sure. I was thinking of the flower or the buttons, but I think these are also looking nice. So can I have something in contrast, like here I'll have this one in the orange, and I'll have a yellow one for the yellow flower. I think that will look good. Okay, now this looks really great. This looks really beautiful. Now for sticking these, again I'm going to have my glue drop, but here I am going to cut this into two pieces. Why? Because my flower buttons are a little smaller, so I will just fold it in half. So this is actually the 1/4 size of glue drop, and I'll stick it on my I should stick it in the contrast, I think. Yeah, I think that looks, this looks much better and good. Again, I'll fold it into half. I'll take up this one. I will stick this, and then I will be using, oh, this looks pretty good. This looks nice to me. Now let me take everything aside. And now it's time to seal this up. And yes, of course, I have not done any other sealing work on this. So what I'm going to do is I am going to use my water-based varnish. I am sharing the link of all these supplies down in the description box. Make sure that you check all the links so that you can buy them directly from the websites. And I am going to use my varnish on my paper flowers also. Now this is something which has been asked to me many a times, that why do I use my varnishes on my flowers also? Because now many times I have been asked that why I use my varnish on my flowers also. So I use it only because to add some more extra strength to my flowers and add a little more stiffness to my flowers, which I personally like. Now it's completely up to you. If you want, you can add it as an extra sealer. If you don't want, you can definitely remove that step. Like you can't, you can just ignore that step, and you can just cover up the varnish on the remaining areas. So yeah, here this is done, and now I'm going to let this dry completely. I'll do a couple of more coats of varnish on this, and yes, with this my project is done. And now if I put this lid on my bottle, can you really see that how beautiful this looks? So yes, thank you so much for watching. Take care guys, and do let me know if you want me to make tutorial on something else, any of the kind of artwork. I'll definitely try to put up a video tutorial very soon. And one more thing, that I have made up a long list. I just want to show you that I have made a long list of artwork which you guys have requested. This is a long list, and I'm going to making these videos and upload it really soon. So yes, thank you so much for watching guys. Take care, bye.